dear students, hope you are doing well. Today we will start our reader lesson. We will discuss about how to prepare for exams. How will you prepare for exam? We have to go through the syllabus first, isn't it? Syllabus means our portions. Make sure that our portions are completed. The second important thing is exam date sheet. Exam date sheet means our timetable. So if you are equipped with your portions, that is syllabus and timetable, you can start preparing for the exam. So our first lesson is about exam. So we can move on to the lesson. Dear children, take your textbook, listen carefully. Teacher will read the text. You should also read the text along with me and underline the new words. Children, our first lesson's name is the English exam. The main characters in this lesson are Raku. He's a student, Raku's teacher and Raku's mother. The main characters are Raku, Raku's teacher and Raku's mother. So now I'll read the lesson. Listen carefully. Raku was very excited. He had his English exam that day. It was his favorite subject. So we have seen that Raku was very excited. Why? Because he had his English exam that day and English was his favorite subject. What do you mean by favorite? Favorite meaning preferred to all others. So English was his favorite subject. English is my favorite subject. I hope I do well in my exam today. So Raku's favorite subject is English and he is very excitedly waiting for the English exam. Soon it was time for the exam to begin. The teacher started distributing the question papers. Raku waited impatiently. So the teacher started distributing the question paper and Raku waited impatiently. What do you mean by impatiently? Impatiently means eagerly waiting for. Eagerly waiting for. So he was eagerly waiting to write the English exam. I'm so eager to write the exam. I wonder if questions on my favorite lessons will be included. So he wonders whether the favorite questions from the lessons will be included in the question paper. So here also we come across a new word, that is eager. Eager meaning strongly wanted to do or have something. Strongly wanted to do or have something. When Raku got his question paper, he was shocked. He couldn't believe his eyes. What happened? When he got the question paper, he was shocked. We'll see what happened. There are 4 spoons and 6 plates on each table. How many? What is this? This is not the English paper. Ma'am, there is something wrong. When he read the question, he thought that there is something wrong. From the question itself, we understood that it is not English question paper. It is maths question paper. Yes. So he informed teacher that there is something wrong with the question paper. The whole class looked at Raku. They couldn't understand what was wrong. So the whole class looked at Raku and they couldn't understand what is wrong with the question paper. What's the matter, Raku? Are you all right? Teacher asked him, what's the matter? There's been a mistake, ma'am. This is a maths paper. So he informed his teacher that this is a maths question paper. The teacher spoke kindly to Raku. Of course, it's maths. Today is the maths exam. No, no, it can't be. Today is the English exam. So teacher told him that today you have maths exam. But Raku said that, no ma'am, today we have English exam. Everyone was surprised at Raku's words. I think you must have mixed up the date sheet. Did you check the date sheet? So the teacher asked him, Did you check the date sheet? What do you mean by date sheet? Timetable. So, did you check the timetable? Yes, ma'am. I had checked it this morning. Today, we were supposed to have our English exam. Again, he is saying that today we're supposed to have English exam. Rekhu was in tears. He didn't know what to do. He just stared at the paper. So he was totally confused. He don't know what to do. And he just stared at the paper. What do you mean by stared? Stare meaning look at something with great concentration. Stare meaning look at something with great concentration. Rekhu, don't be so upset. Read the questions. I'm sure you will be able to answer most of them. So the teacher tried to console him and said that, Rekhu, don't worry. I'm sure you will be able to answer most of the questions. You just try. But I had prepared for English today. Well, the English exam is tomorrow. Rekhu was totally confused and couldn't think clearly. He couldn't think clearly. What if I do badly in maths? It was supposed to be the English exam today. So it was supposed to be the English exam today and I prepared only for English. So what if I do with maths question paper? Now, in the next page you can see, Rekhu kept on speaking to himself. Now we can see the picture. He is in his bed. It was supposed to be English today. I know it was supposed to be English today. In the textbook, you can see he is on his bed and he is murmuring that it was supposed to be English today. Rekhu's mother noticed him kicking around in his bed, murmuring something or muttering something. So Rekhu's mother came there and noticed that he is murmuring or muttering something. What do you mean by muttering? Muttering means murmuring or say something in a low voice. Muttering means murmuring or say something in a low voice. Rekhu, wake up. You must be having a bad dream. Wake up. Oh, mummy, where am I? In your bed, of course. So his mother told him that you are in your bed. Don't worry. Rekhu looked around. He was indeed in his bed at home. It must have been a dream. Oh, mummy, I had such a bad dream. Rekhu now started sharing about his dream with his mother. Calm down and tell me all about it. So his mother said, calm down, dear child. Tell me about your dream. Rekhu told his mother about his dream. Mummy, I dreamt that I went to the school to appear for my English exam. I found that we had the maths exam that day. I was in such a panic. So he shared about his dream with his mother and he told her that I was in such a panic. What do you mean by panic? Panic means sudden uncontrollable fear. Panic means sudden uncontrollable fear. Oh, you poor boy. Have you forgotten your exams are over? Today is your first holiday. Relax and enjoy your holidays. So Rekhu's mother tried to console him and said that, relax, today is your first holiday. Relax and enjoy your holidays. So I hope you understood the lesson. Just we will revise the lesson again. In the beginning, we have seen that Rekhu was very excited to write the English exam. But when he went to the exam hall, he got maths question paper instead of English. And he informed his teacher and teacher told him that today we have maths exam. He was totally confused. He don't know what to do. And then he realized that it was only his dream. His mother consoled him and he felt so relaxed. Now, in this lesson, we have seen many new words, isn't it? So, the new words are here, favorite, impatiently, eager, stare, muttering, panic. We have discussed all the meanings also. Now, we are moving on to the first activity, that is make sentence. First word is favorite. Can you make a sentence with favorite? Here I have given a sentence. My favorite color is pink. My favorite color is pink. Like this, you can also prepare a sentence with the word favorite. The next word is eager. I am so eager to write the exam. I am so eager to write the exam. So children, you also have to prepare a sentence with the word eager. The next word is stared. Raku stared at the question paper. Raku stared at the question paper. So using these three words, you also have to prepare sentences. Now it's time for the activity. Here I have given three words. You have to make sentences with these three words. First one is panic, second one is excited, third one is impatiently. So try to make sentences with these words and we will discuss during the online session. Moving on to the second activity, we have seen in this lesson, Raku's favorite subject is English. So, dear children, you also have to prepare a paragraph about your favorite subject. You can write 10 sentences about your favorite subject and you can discuss it during the online session with your friends and teacher. Write it in your book. So dear children, read the lesson many times and underline the new words. Go through the video several times. Complete the activities. So I hope everything is clear to you. Thank you.